Okay.
And Pat, you're going to be on your best behavior, right?
Bingo, Beth. I'm just pumped to be here.
You know who else is pumped to be here? This young lady.
This beautiful one ball. Introducing first from the West Valley, Tegan Knox.
You know, Tegan Knox is showing. Indy Hartwell, she's been developing a style that's going to make waves in NXT. I've been seeing her come into her own and begin playing to her strengths. She's got a physical style that leans heavily on power moves, and she's got one ruthless big boot.
And Hartwell coming off her first victory in NXT, knocking off Shotzi Blackheart, but Robert Stonebrand had a little something to do with that.
You're here on commentary in NXT. A little animosity in our women's division.
I saw a little beef there. I saw a big slap. Shotzi Blackheart is kind of getting in between these two. And I will say, aside from North America, Australia is my favorite continent, but came in a little disrespectful there.
I remember the last time that you got to be on commentary in the entire WWE was a pretty eventful night. SmackDown, November 1st, 2019. It's actually when this brand took over SmackDown. You remember that night?
Yeah, the best SmackDown in the history of SmackDown, Tom. It was an honor to share the booth with you then alongside Renee. And here I am living out a dream. Yet again,
slam the cover. Sorry, Pat. Indy Hartwell looking for a second consecutive victory.
Moro, you don't have to be sorry to me, pal. Anytime you need to speak, you go ahead and do it. People need to hear your voice more than mine, pal. But it's an honor to be in here. This is a dream come true.
And you took time out of your honeymoon. You got a sunburn in the midst of that. It's great. You know, you seem like you've turned over a new leaf.
You know, anything to get back in the good graces of not only Adam Cole, but the NXT locker room, the NXT brand as a whole. I took it. I was down here getting a sun kiss, you know, for the honeymoon. I get invited over here, and I couldn't wait to get in.
And a cover here by Indy Hartwell, looking for her second straight win, looking for the biggest win against Tegan Knox.
No. You know, Pat, you're a high-level athlete. You've been in a lot of high-pressure situations. How did you handle those big moments like these young ladies are having right now?
You know, I think I was kind of an anomaly. I was so dumb, I didn't even know that I was in those massive situations. And there is something to that. You know, there is something for the paralysis by over-analysis. So for me, I just had that perfect, steady stupidity level where I didn't overthink things. These ladies are obviously much better athletes.
By Knox for a quick one count. Oh, and the big boot to the face. Hartwell going for another major victory. Yeah. And Knox able to kick out.
And Pat, you're obviously talking about your time in the National Football League. You played for the Indianapolis Colts. You're an all-pro, and now you've turned it over into this extraordinarily successful show, the Pat McAfee Show. And, you know, you do a really good job. You know, you stir up some controversy here and there, and some things happen.
I'm not a big controversy guy, actually. I kind of hate the controversy, but every once in a while, something can get misconstrued, which is what happened with Adam, which I believe you're alluding to.
Yes.
This seems like a little leading journalism, what you're doing.
Just ask him.
The show normally upbeat, good time. So whenever it popped off with Adam the way it did, I didn't expect it. Nobody expected it. And that's why I was so excited to make it.
Knox attempting to stomp a mud hole in Indy Hartwell. Knox again. Cannon Bore. And Knox looking to remain in championship contention. There's the shiniest wizard on Indy Hartwell. Tegan Knox.
Wow.
Triumph.
Wow. Knee to the mouth. That was explosive. Legendary. That was something that I would like to see again.
Well, you very well may get that chance as Tegan Knox is on a roll and determined to keep her career.